Hi, everybody. My name is Rene Vogt-Lowell, and I work in the Emerging Technologies Department of Ed Services with Shankar. And I guess I'm encouraged to talk a lot of SMAC, social, mobile, analytics, and cloud, and try to come up with interesting ways of teaching those concepts.
And my name is Paul Brant. I'm also in Education Services in the Emerging Trends Group, and I've been focusing lately on DevOps and open source and other emerging trends and technology.
I was interested in writing a paper when I first started. I'm a newbie, so I've only been here since, I guess, January of 2014. And I got to meet Paul and talk to him about a lot of things, just being on my team in emerging technologies. And he'd obviously done this before, and we had chat about that in the process, and it sounded really exciting. So he invited me to take a look into doing this as a collaborative approach, and it was about a topic that I was very near and dear to, having been an application developer for a long time. So it was really exciting to jump into something and kind of write something about our combined experiences in that area.
From my perspective, you know, I've done this a few times, and you know, I'm thankful that I was able to do it. And you know, when I met Rene, Rene and I have been working for a while. And you know, one great thing that I like about Rene is his ability to be artistic and to he was a developer, and I'm more on the infrastructure technology side. So I thought that we had some good synergy there.
Yeah.
And you know, and hopefully it came out in the paper.
We initially looked at another topic, but we realized that application development was becoming more and more profoundly affecting EMC, and it made more sense to maybe jump into that and kind of dive through what's involved and how it's shaping the transformation from looking at hardware in a certain way to making it more about the application and how its software defines the use of the hardware. So yeah, I think that was the impetus to begin with, yeah.
Exactly, and adding to that is the application developer is really becoming the kingmaker.
Yep.
It's what's making businesses agile, and it's really driving the industry. So we felt that, you know, that's a really cool, you know, topic to discuss.
And
that was our driving.
Yeah, yeah. Empowering the application developers.
Exactly. You
know, got a lot of help from a proven professional on just trying to understand what was expected, and just working with Paul, he'd been through this, as I'd mentioned before, several times, so he kind of led me through a lot of the hoops and what was expected in the past. So a lot of new grounds there and a lot of people there to help us out.
Exactly. And in terms of proven professional, you know, everyone's becoming a person that has to think out of the box. So part of our, you know, our production was not only the paper, but also a video that we did together. And we feel that the importance of, you know, having multiple modalities, right, of delivering a message and, you know, and best practices makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Yeah, it touches upon just being able to really feel emotionally attached to the data and not so much about just the data itself. So having those multiple modalities made it a little more exciting to engage in teaching on that front. And there's a section in the paper just on thinking inside, out of the box, too, now that Paul's bringing that up.
So it's
not so much thinking outside of the box by itself, but having lived in the box first so you can kind of know what the constraints are and then don't invalidate those so that things can still leverage what they were expecting to have in the past and then still be able to creatively move forward. So it's a great topic. A Day in the Life of an Application Developer is the title of the paper and the music video that goes along with it. And if you're going into it blind, that's probably the best way. because it's going to hit you like a ton of bricks in a good or a bad way. It's just we went all out with trying to tie the two together, the paper and the music video. So it's trying to understand the good, the bad, and the ugly of what it means to be an application developer, the amount of responsibility and power that comes with that role, and just learning who are all your stakeholders and your audiences and the different technologies and the social awareness of that role that needs to take place. There's no sleepful moment as in that role, and you need to be aware of all those things that are going to be coming at you at once. So we try to tackle it from many different perspectives on that. Do you want to?
Exactly. You know, in addition, an application developer needs to be both a left brain and right brain person.
Yeah.
Right? You need to understand the technology, the operations. You need to understand DevOps. You need to understand how all that works, extreme programming. But you also have to be able to create and be creative, because that's what's driving, you know, the web scale developers out there. That's what's really driving value, be it the Uber, be it, you know, Facebook or, you know, Twitter. These developers need to think at a business level, and how do you drive that? So we kind of provide the tools as well as the methodologies and approaches that will make somebody a really great developer.
Yeah, I mean, and to go off of that point a little bit, I mean, marrying both the left and the right side is very important. At the end of the day, the thing that gets created is not just the logic, but the passion that drove you to use the logic to create something in the first place. So it's very helpful to be able to look at what you're gonna need to be able to get something done, and also the why of what you're doing it, so that you can constantly drive yourself to complete things and see all the relationships between the data points you're trying to connect.
Exactly, so. And the main theme of this paper is DevOn.
DevOn,
watch
yes.
the video.
Gotta repeat that, DevOn.
DevOn.
I'm trying to burn that in everybody's brain here, so yeah.
Exactly.
The main audience is going to be the application developers, but it's also going to be those who are going to employ the application developers. It's going to be those who are going to work with the application developers. So it's pretty much everybody that is going to be interfacing to some degree with them and knowing what's involved and what's needed and what the expectations are.
And in addition, it also involves people involved in infrastructure and technology, because the concept of DevOps is development and operations.
Right.
So the operation guys need to understand the challenges and goals of the application developer and vice versa.
Right, right, right. A lot of communication back and forth, just being able to know where everyone's dependencies are. It's a very big theme in there. Not necessarily to expand on the topic of nothing for all versus something for some, not so much that there are some application developers that do only one or the other, but that try to position that as a cautionary point for all application developers as well as those that are working with, because it becomes a incentive to try to include too many things in an application when you are brainstorming. You know, when you're first coming up with a conceptual idea, it's very easy to say, oh, it's going to do everything. Because you get all excited, you get all glitzy-eyed, you get enough people in a room who are creative and they're stakeholders, and we're all going to try to massage as much functionality into something as we can. And oftentimes that can result in the nothing for all solutions, when instead of focusing on a niche thing you're trying to solve and doing that really, really well, you do a little bit of everything, and it's almost like the jack of all trades, master of none concept. So the push we're trying to put on that side of the paper is that it's okay to tailor back. It's okay to uphold the subset of functionality you said at the beginning and kind of maintain that flag and that outpost while you guide the rest of the team forward. And each person takes turns guiding the team. It's not just the application developer's job, but it does start often with them, because they're going to be the ones most closely attached to the development of functionality. So just some cautionary information there.
Right. And speaking of cautionary, you know, application developers can yield or wield a lot of power in the sense of, you know, of doing the right thing, of making sure that the application itself is consistent with you know, social, you know, goals. And that's kind of what we try to push through it, right?
Yeah. They're in tune with the audience and the people using the application. As an application developer trying to balance that, it would be very important that early on there's this concept of requirements and desirements, and we talk about the different versions of working through an application, waterfall versus agile, is the two big proponents that go head to head. But regardless of your software development lifecycle, it's important to have a lot of good conversation early on, a lot of good brainstorming, a lot of bringing in all the key decision makers, and being able to say, okay, some of these functionalities are great, but they're more on a desirements level. Do they really achieve the true responsibility of the application as we deem it from the beginning? Is it trying to solve X, Y, and Z? Then maybe A, B, and C would be nice add-ons, but let's keep those on a desirements list basis. And there's a lot of different ways you can go about doing that, but just constantly having those conversations and being cognizant about, let's bring it back to, you know, minimum viable product. What were we trying to set out to do? Does it achieve just the minimum? Then let's keep it to that, and then later on as we iterate through the application, we'll maybe add those as it becomes, it makes sense to.
It's all about driving from business value through production, through operations, and you know, achieving that in a viable way, you know, through agile methodologies, you know, is really the way to go. For EMC Proven Professional, I think it's important that everyone within EMC, or as well as EMC customers, understand the importance of the application developer and understand that they're really the people that infrastructure supports. That's why the infrastructure is there.
Yeah.
And so understanding what the application developer really does is the coolest part, or it should be the coolest part of our business.
Yeah, and it's a little strange to endorse that as an application developer, because it can come across as some kind of hubris or just cockiness that that's the most important thing instead of the foundation. That's never really the intent. It's just that if the end result that's going to be the most visible is the application, mm-hmm. we need to have more visibility into what the needs of the application developers are so that they can achieve that. And back to your question earlier about how do you balance, that's one of the questions, right? How do we make it so that there's not so many constraints that have to be adhered to by the application developer so that they end up just producing something that just meets the minimum needs instead of something that is extremely innovative? Mm-hmm. So just that's part of the rationale behind the paper as well. It's just trying to have awareness of what the needs are for application developers, trying to think creatively outside of the box with constraints.
And for me, one last thing is, working together, working as a team, developing a paper is very in line with agile mm-hmm. development processes, extreme programming.
Oh, yeah.
It's bouncing ideas off of each other. So I would recommend
often.
Anyone who wants to do a paper, definitely make it a collaborative effort. You'll definitely gain from it.
Yeah. We had a lot of fun doing it. There was a lot of awesome yeah. ideas back and forth.
There will be a reverse at the end, I promise. I read the news today, oh boy, about a lucky man who made abs brains, and all the news made others mad. Well, I just had to laugh. Saw the golden grass. He blew his coat out in a jar. He didn't notice that the specs had changed. A crowd of developers stood and stared. They'd seen his face before. Nobody was really sure if he was from the house of death. Agile army had just won the war. A crowd of developers turned away. But I just had to look, having read the book.
Fell out of bed, dragged a comb across my head. Found my way downstairs and drank a Java cup. And looking up, I noticed I was late. Found my coat and grabbed my hat. Made the bus in seconds flat. Found my way upstairs and made a cold joke. And somebody spoke,
no!
And I went into a dream.
4,000 bucks, a hacker shed a tear. And though the bugs were rather small, he had to count them all. Now they know how many bugs it takes to do the reef by the time.
Don't talk. Start over.
Start over.
All right, go ahead. Bow slowly. Okay, and do that even slower.
Even slower. Let's go.
Okay, no, no, just start now. What?
Action. 1/1000, 2/1000, 3/1000, 4/1000, 5/1000, 6/1000. Good.
Boy, we are good.
Not good.